Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Shea Stadium for the third game of the 1969 World Series. Here are the official lineups.
Meet the Mets. Meet the Mets. Step right up and greet the Mets. Bring your kiddies, bring your wife. Guaranteed to have the time of your life, because the Mets are really something to fall. Knocking those home runs over the wall. East side, west side, everybody's coming down to meet the M-E-T-S Mets of New York.
In 1968, the New York Mets had wound up in ninth place, a record that would have been an embarrassment for some teams, but represented only the second time the Mets had soared so high. When the 1969 season opened, the odds against their winning the pennant were 100-1. And true to form, they dropped 7 of their first 10 games. But they now had a superb manager and a fastballer from Texas named Nolan Ryan. They were soon locked in a season-long struggle for first place.
So the Mets are one out away from their impossible dream.
They won 38 of their last 49 games to take the Eastern Division title by 8 games.
Garrett has the ball, a throw to first.
Then swept the Atlanta Braves for the pennant. But Earl Weaver's Orioles, the best team in baseball that year, were waiting for them in Baltimore. As expected, the Mets lost the first game 4-1, but they came back to take the second behind the brilliant pitching of Jerry Kuzman. And then the Orioles came to Shea Stadium, where the Mets and 56,000 of their fans were waiting for them. New York won the third game 5-0.
In a year of change and surprise across baseball and America, the Mets were suddenly in position to deliver perhaps the biggest shocker of all. Up 2-1 in the 1969 World Series, with New York in a fit of excitement, Mets 25-game winner Tom Seaver went to the mound in Game 4, aiming to put the series further out of reach. Seaver and the Mets held a 1-0 lead for 8 innings. Then, in the top of the ninth, with a runner on third and one out, another amazing outfield play curbed an Oriole rally.
And there's a drive to right center. Robota comes up with it. The game is tied. Bota making another sensational catch for the Mets.
The game went to the 10th, tied. And in the bottom of the frame, fate appeared to intervene once more as J.C. Martin was hit by a Pete Rickard throw, allowing Rod Gaspar to dash home with the winning score.
Here comes the winning run. The Mets win the ballgame by a score of 2-1.
Improbably, the Mets had a 3-1 series lead and a chance to clinch the World Series at Shea the next afternoon. The Orioles took a 3-0 lead.
Bring him out.
But by now it was clear the odds meant little to the Mets.
Leon skipping to get out of the way, and it's ball one.
In the sixth, the McNally pitch to Cleon Jones appeared to bounce away. But when Mets manager Gil Hodges presented a ball with a shoe polish stain on it to the umpires, Jones was awarded first base. The polish was the beginning of the end for the Orioles, as Clendenin followed with a homer.
A home run for Clendenin.
And after Kuzman settled down,
breaking pitch in
for a Ron Swoboda gave the Mets a lead they would never surrender.
Jones is coming home. There'll be no play at the plate. The Mets are leading by a score of 4-3.
From there, it was just a matter of time.
The
team that couldn't had become the team that did.
Look at this scene.
Never before and never since has there been a more unlikely world champion than the 1969 New York Mets.
We come to play. This is a club that played this way all year long. We came from behind. We did it today because we never put our heads between our legs, and we always fought. And it's the greatest feeling in the world.